you'll start another little section here. And the same goes for wood and rock. I believe it probably is the same for a lot of materials, like base materials. But things such as like first aid bandages, you can only carry up to, I think it's like 5 or 10. 5 or 10 tops. Painkillers, vitamins, etc. Antibiotics, they go up to like 50, I believe. I'm not sure about the glass jars. Glass jars are used for water collection, boiling eggs, as long as you're next to a fire, etc., etc. And this is my house. This is actually my primary fort. I planted a bunch of trees around some time ago before I stopped playing for about a month or two. And they look so pretty. Look at this. Reminds me of, it's very fantasy. I like it. I'd like to surround the entire house with these, actually. Maybe cut down a couple of close ones, because they're actually, this one right here, these two close ones. All the leaves are going through the house upstairs, and I don't really care for that. So actually, let's chop some of these down. This one right here too. It was literally like a dream come true when I finally got to create this axe. It's a very nice axe. There are many like it, but this one is mine. This beats the stone axe by leaps and bounds. Oh, that hurt. I'm bleeding. I'm bleeding. It's a first aid bandage here. Stop the bleeding, and since it's a first aid bandage, it'll also repair. I can slowly heal. These spikes are a lot more... Gotta be careful around these guys, man. That. I might have that a couple of leaves coming through the inside of the house from that guy right there. I'm not sure if I'll chop that one down though. Or you can run for as long as you have stamina. Stamina's in the blue. It'll slowly deplete depending on if you're running or the condition your body's in. You can actually get stuff like Dysteria. If you get Dysteria, your stamina will deplete, etc., etc. I think actually stamina and health I think started at 100, but I met some status inflictions, etc., and I dropped it down quite a bit. And I haven't got them back up yet. So bandages are five stacks. Yeah, painkillers are 50. Antibiotics probably are too. Got some splints. I've only found 3 blood bags. I've got 1 vitamin here. I'm gonna hold on to this in case I need it. It will slowly heal you, but you will dehydrate. So if you use painkillers, you need to make sure you have some water, or you can get some water. Sometimes I get a little lost as to what to do. Oh, I've actually got some landmines. That's nice. Snow. If you end up in the snowy part of the map, you can dig some snow up and you can boil that down for water. anything in there. You can add up to 3 stacks of 1,000 pieces of wood for your fuel in the fire pit. I've already added a cooking pot, cooking drill, and a beaker. Depending on what you have up here, you can only cook or create certain items at your fire. Turn it on. It tells you how much time you got. So this will let me have continuous fire for about 326 minutes. And if I add another stack right here, you can see it go up to 442. And I'll go ahead and leave those there. I do have about 6 maple seeds, so I can plant some more trees outside, which I think I will do. At least eventually. A green puffer coat. I hold on to that in case I go out into the snow. Provides 30 degrees of protection. If you go into the snowy parts unprepared, you will freeze. So right now I don't really need that. I forget what paper can be used for. Maybe to create some TNT. Shotgun ammo, blunderbuss ammo, TNT, and more. But wait, there's more. I built myself a little bunker down here. Check this out. All these zombies following me, so. Actually, I already been down here a little while ago. I added some iron to my forge. Every piece of iron gives you 5 plus 5 iron. Oh no! What's going on? I'm thirsty. I need to drink something. Oh, I need some water. I'm gonna die. Thirsty. Oh, this is an emergency. Oh, I need something to drink. What do I got? Some goldenrod tea. What'll that do for me? Cures dysentery. I am not sure why I am losing health so much, but this has me very concerned. Well, so my food's good, my water. Brought that up to 54. That was weird. I don't understand that. Alright, so let's continue. I haven't worked down here in quite some time. Let's just go ahead and put some work in. I do have a pickaxe I can use. Once you add materials to smelt, you can add iron, brass, lead, glass, stone, and clay. And depending on what you have, I have 0 brass and very little lead. Depending on what you've got in the numbers over here, It gives you a list of stuff you can build right here. And you got pages. Ooh, I can build a mini bike chassis. Actually, I can't. I have the materials to do it, but I do not have the book read. So I can't build that. Most of it I'm not really needing to build right now, though. I can build some fence. Some wrought iron fence. I got... That might be kind of cool. Oh yeah, I did. I got concrete now. I'm not exactly sure what I'm supposed to do with the concrete, really, but or cement. I'm sorry, I have cement, so I can make flagstone and concrete once I bought the concrete perk. But I think I also need like a concrete mixer. And I have no idea where that's at. Anyway, I don't need a fire round for this, so I can shut this off. So yeah, I can keep improving my situation here. Some food. Oh yeah, I probably put it in my supply. Duh. There it is right there, grilled meat. Look at that. I got four steaks. Four steaks, two baked potatoes, some boiled eggs. Honey. Honey's cool. It will cure you of dysentery. Always good to have some beer on hand, some goldenrod tea. Got some blueberries. Potato seeds are awesome. Can't wait to plant those somewhere when I get a garden going or something like that. Some chrysanthemum will make, actually, let's get some. I already got some right here. This will make some kind of beverage. I'm not sure. I forget what it's called. Yeah, like I said, it's been a while since I played, so I'm a little rusty. I'm just trying to get back into the hang of things. Taking a little bit to learn what I'm doing here again. Oh yeah, look at that. Those leaves are gone. That's awesome. I did leave this open so I can see. I can see who's coming at my door. If I don't like them, I can shoot them. Pew, pew. This is my little lookout. I pretty much just did this a couple months ago before I stopped playing for a little bit. I built this up here. And right after I did that, actually, the last thing I did, there's the map. Here's me. There's my little house. Right there. I wanted to know how big this map was, so I started. I found some red zone, which is, I guess, the edge of the map. You go into that, you will die. It takes a couple seconds, but you will die. Anyway, I followed it all the way around so I knew where my map was and how big it was. Took a little while, died a couple times, but it is now done. This is actually one of the first cities I found, if not the first big city I found. I don't know if there's any more big ones like that, but... Mm-hmm. Giggity. I found some really nice stuff over here, though. And I do have a very nice little fort set up, I think, up on top of one of these roofs. If I end up over that way anytime soon, I'll show you what I'm talking about. A little cabin up here in the woods. It's my snow retreat. It's pretty nice, this house right here. There was actually a forge in here already built. If I would have known that, that would have been pretty cool. So I still have a lot of the map to explore. Especially over here in the southwest. Like, wow. All uncharted territory. And even in the Midwest right here. Thought I heard something. No, I can't get back up there. Oh yeah, there we go. See, now they're gonna try to come over here and break my stuff. Bastards. Deal with my spikes first. Fucking horde, dude. Oh, they're gonna destroy my entire house if I don't get out of here. Just make them follow me. And just a heads up, do not cook steak and eggs at your residence. You cook steak and eggs at your residence, you're gonna get a big party full of zombies that want your steak and eggs, and your brains too. And they will destroy your entire house to get to it. I learned that the hard way. This game is not absolutely perfect. It does have its errors. Like that. Look at that. The game does get... they constantly improve the game in updates. And every time they make an update, it usually improves some aspect of the game. So over time, perhaps a couple of years, few years, this game will be entirely different, perhaps, than what you see right now. It is relatively cheap as far as price goes. I believe you can pick it up for about $30 new. Published by Telltale Games. Developed by the Fun Pimps. And I really have to hand it to the Fun Pimps because I don't have a gaming PC, so I cannot play DayZ. Which, you know, would be really cool if I could play DayZ. If I put this to a little bit of shame, to be completely honest. But since I don't have access to that and I can't do that, the Fun Pimps have pulled through and gave us a survival horde crafting game. It's a lot like Minecraft. And it has a lot of DayZ elements to it, I would think. It's always, always good to find food. So nails are ammo for the nail gun. Nail gun is awesome. I used it in a previous game where everything was already unlocked. And you didn't really have to figure it all out as you go. So I got to check some things out and sample things. This is pretty nice. I really cannot wait to be able to build my own nail gun or find one. It is very useful. Especially for base building. You can eat these rotten sandwiches, an old sham sandwich. You can eat them, but it will probably poison you. And then you're going to have to deal with a whole bunch of shit. So you really only ever want to eat these if you are literally going to die from hunger. And it's an emergency. And you can kind of buy yourself a little bit of time. But you will have to eventually cure whatever ailment you get, which is probably dysentery. That's getting picked up in my mic all day. Let me turn the volume down on that. I'm just watching a little Fantastic Beasts. Airdrops. Airdrops will show up on your map. Chill, man. I think I needed to kick my heat on here. I'm gonna plant some trees. I'm gonna plant one right here. So after I quit playing, after I planted those guys, I didn't get a chance to see how long it takes for these to grow. That looks pretty quick already, look at that. That's nice. So we'll let that one grow, we can throw one right here. Maybe. I'll throw one right there. Throw another one right here. Somewhere. Empty bird's nest. I've only ever found eggs and feathers in them. I don't think you get anything if you destroy the nest itself. And they do randomly generate throughout the world, I believe. But you can find them all over the place, as long as you look on the ground. Sometimes the grass makes it hard to see them. Can't remember where I planted the last one at. Okay, right there. And right there. So let's build. I got two more I can throw up. Let's throw them. Let's put one over here. Let's put one right over here. Give me a nice little Nice little bit of shade there on my front porch, maybe, from that setting sun. Took down most of this. This will give you stone. It's much easier to get stone this way instead of picking up the single stones off the ground, which the single stones are typically what you start the game with. You don't really have any weapons, materials, or anything to mine or collect with, so you basically are just foraging with your own little two hands. Well, once you start leveling and creating new gear and making new items, you will be able to build things like the pickaxe, and it makes it a hell of a lot easier, which is fantastic. It looks like I'm getting some sand there too. At least I think it's sand. Cotton's good for, actually I don't remember what the hell cotton's good for. Let's go find out. Recipes, so I can get some cotton seed. I can make it, ooh, I can make an old bed. Oh, so it basically serves the same purpose as a sleeping bag. You place it on the ground and that's where you respawn once you die. You can either choose to respawn at your bed or near your bed. Oh, a king size bed even. Wow. See, I won't be able to build that for quite some time if that takes 20 springs. I've only got 10 springs, I think, total, at least at this house. And that is after 37 in-game days. So the trick with this game, a lot of you have probably played this. If you have, you know exactly what I'm talking about, and everything I've told you so far is basically just annoying, perhaps, and repetitive. The thing about this game here, it's a very, very Minecraft-like game. The only difference is it's obviously a zombie survival game. You collect, you craft, and build. Zombies can't destroy anything you build, so you gotta be careful. Every 7 days that passes in the game is a blood moon. When the blood moon comes up, it is a horde. A horde is set out after you in the game, and you have to survive that. So like rotting flesh, I don't need that. I'm not going to eat it, it'll make you sick. I don't really need these bones. You can make a shiv with it, which you can use to skin animal hides, etc., etc. But I do have... or at least I thought I had a knife, which usually works, I suppose, but... Yeah, see, I got some crushed sand. Alright, so you can put sand in the forge. I don't think I knew that. Sandbags are not very sturdy, but can be put down quickly and provide decent protection from bullets. So if I'm gonna need protection from bullets, is that because of other players in the game? Because I don't see any NPCs running around with bullets. Pardon me for just a moment. I'm checking my thermostat here. I still don't, I'm not used to it. I've actually never had a thermostat and it's kind of freaking me out. There we go. Heat's back on. It's starting to get a little chilly, man. So I don't like it at 65. We're gonna kick it up to 66 and see how that goes. I am very, very excited to bring you this gameplay, guys. So I'm really, really hot. Let's go ahead and take some clothes off here before I start overheating. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of, let's go ahead, let's just get naked, man. Let's take some pants off, too. Look at that. Oh, yeah. I'm bringing in the zombie apocalypse, right? Streaking through the quad. And that's what the wrench is good for. I'm actually not going to waste my time with that. I don't even know if I'll get anything useful out of this other than some iron or some metal of some sort. See, our temperature's still coming down. I probably could use some food and water, so let's go ahead and let's eat some stuff here. I'm not gonna eat the dog food. I don't have that much, actually. Let's go back to the house. Typically, when it gets dark in this game, the zombies do run. They run at nighttime, and they walk during the day. But I've actually gone and made mine custom, because the running zombies were literally freaky, and I didn't like it. So I made zombies never run. You guys can call me a wuss all you want, but whatever. Food. Water. I got plenty of water right now on me. Let's eat some steak. Let's have one of these. Let's eat two steaks. Yeah, let's eat two steaks. If you carry this on your tool belt, this is your tool belt. And if you carry any food that stinks on your tool belt, you will attract zombies. So you need to be careful. My food's at 58. Alright, one steak and it brought up from 58 to 72 and it just dropped down to 71. Chicken soup actually serves two purposes. It will give you plus 5 fullness, but it also gives you 10 hydration. So if you don't have any water and you're dying of thirst, and you do have soup, that will probably work. You'll be left with the empty can, which you can then use for water collection. Or you can scrap it for one iron. Since I already have some water here, I'm going to go ahead and just scrap that. Right. think I will keep these empty jars in case I find some water. Ooh, I got chili. I wanna eat the chili too. So food's up to 92, and my hydration should be around 100, so I think we're pretty good. Yeah, 92 and 93. It's starting to get nighttime and chilly, so let's go ahead and put my pants back on. And let's kick on my shirt. Now temperature's still dropping, so let's go ahead and keep warm. Let's put this on. How much does this got? This has 5 degrees of insulation. And now we're going back up. So let's go ahead and rock this and see what happens. I'm going to make sure everything here is set and settled away, and then I'm going to go on an adventure. Okay, I'm going to store the dog food. I don't want that. I don't want to bring that with me. Get rid of some crap I don't need real quick first, and then we'll go out and head on our way. Alright, there's my weapon crate. I do have an SMG. I'm not going to use it though. I only got 60 bullets for it, and I do have a couple pistol rounds, so I'm just going to rock the pistol and my bow and arrow. I cannot wait to get a rifle for that 7.62 ammo. That's going to be nice. I'm storing all my stuff down, I guess, in the basement of my crafting material. So let's go down here and throw it down here. And this little crate right here. Oh, brilliant. Look at that. Let's actually throw our sand over there. And let's put our nails. So now it is full-blown nighttime. And wolves are howling at the moon. And let's go. Wait, I need food. Duh. Okay, so I got nails. Yeah, okay. Well, I put the one nail downstairs anyway. That's not a big deal. I'm gonna go ahead and bring my bedroll with me. I might throw that down somewhere. And then if I die, I can just res right back there. I'm gonna bring some bandages. I'm not gonna take that. I will need some antibiotics though. Let's take a couple of antibiotics. Hope I don't need them. So let's pick somewhere to go. This is the desert here. It's going to be really warm. You'll overheat pretty easily, so you'll need some water. And over here you will freeze, so you'll need some really warm clothes. Let's go ahead and stick to the green for now. I have not been over here. Let's go ahead and set a waypoint. And that's where we will go. Let's do some exploring. Now, when you don't have any stamina, you will walk. And you will not be able to run. And if you run out of stamina at the wrong time, you're gonna regret it. So you wanna make sure you're keeping an eye on everything. You gotta keep your stats in check. And most certainly always keep an eye on your health. Actually, just last night, I was playing for a little bit, maybe an hour or two, and I was running up a hill just like this, away from zombies, because there was a horde of zombies behind me. And as I'm running up this hill, I'm thinking I'm good, I'm going to get away from these guys. And as soon as I peeked to the top of the hill right here, there was literally a brown bear standing about right here. And I just gave up because I knew I could not run it, and it took about one or two hits and I just died. I did drop everything on my tool belt. And that's all gone forever now. So I don't really remember what I had, but doesn't matter, it's gone. If you're running down hills, you do need to be careful with jumping. You don't want to jump when you're running down a really steep hill. Since you get going so fast running down a hill and you jump, you could break your leg or injure yourself just in general, so be careful. I do need to pick up some feathers because I need to keep replenishing my arrows. You can cross the river with no problem. The only thing that you will get wet, and depending on weather conditions, you might not want to be wet. Can't affect your health and condition in this game. I don't think this is in depth as, say, DayZ, but it's got a certain bit of depth to it. Like in DayZ, you can perform blood transfusions. I'm not sure if that's to get rid of infection or just to replace lost blood, etc. But if you get the wrong type of blood from a character, this is how in depth this game is. You can die or go unconscious because you've got the wrong type of blood in your transfusion. It'd be nice to see this reach that point in 7 days. I don't usually find anything useful in garbage, but every now and again you can get lucky. So here we go, we are in completely uncharted territory. I've never been over here before. This little bloated walker. Oh, he's got some fresh water. Bloated bastard. Let's just go check this house out. There's a zombie. Ooh, yeah, we got a couple zombies, man. I didn't even see them. Did they just pop up? Sometimes I'll carry vitamins, antibiotics, painkillers. So if you're in a pinch for any of those items, I can maybe try and kill you a nurse. Alright. Oh, look at these pretty flowers, man. Just like, is this regular fire? Yeah. Oh, it's like a dock. It's a little, nice. Dude, I've never seen that one. Water. This is a lake. I've never found a lake. Oh, wow, dude. That's awesome. Oh, you can get a boat. So I'm gonna have to get rid of some of these zombies here, man. Oh, I got some sham. I got a can of sham. I'm in trouble. Oh no. Dude, where's my sham? Oh no. Since I didn't pick that up, I think I lost it. They fell over the end of the water. Oh hell yeah, duck. That really sucks, man. Oh, you hear that? You can actually hear the glass. See that can of sham anywhere. So let's just call that lost. Not entirely sure why I'm overheating right now. Damn it, dude. Oh, a deer. Nice little 8-point buck there. Grain alcohol. I don't remember what that's used for, but I'm gonna take it anyway. Alright, so I think I got all them zombies. Now we can explore this little sucker. I'm still overheating. Let's drop it down. Alright, so the only way I'm gonna get in here is to break one of these walls down, apparently. Might have some food in there. Will that stay lit if I throw it down? Excellent, dude. I'm taking that. That's mine. Eating so much, I lost all my hydration. I should turn this into a fort right here next to the lake. It's like unlimited water. only have a water source by my other house. Ooh, I could build an underground tunnel all the way over here too. Connect them. That'd be sweet. Hello? Sir, you all right? This dude went out with a fight, huh? Or maybe he's just hungry? Alright, so I am completely full. My storage. So if I find anything else useful that I want to take, I'm either going to have to destroy something or eat something. Looks like we're mostly empty here anyway. So that's it. I'm not going to mess with this place right now, though. I'm not even going to add a door back. So apparently I want to go to the middle of this lake, but I'm not going to swim in the water. Let's just go around the outskirt, or the outer edges of the lake here. Reveal the map. Almost forgot about my health, guys. That would not have been good at all. Alright, so I am spotted. Oh, there we go. Well, I guess I'm not getting that lead. Dude, what is that? Is that a chicken? Why did the chicken cross the lake? Right, wait, a better question. How the fuck did the chicken cross the lake? That's not a chicken. That is a Jesus chicken. Dude, look at the thing. It's walking on top of the water. Well, hello there, little bitch. So it looks like we have survived another evening. I'm coming over here and check this little house out. This almost looks like a little church. Oh, we got zombies. You bastard. You snuck up on me like a little ninja, huh? Yeah, you want some too, huh? That's something for you. This game definitely requires a little bit of patience. If you don't have patience, I'm not sure that I would recommend this game for you at all. Oh, treasure map, dude, I'm taking... Oh yeah, Claude. Water! Always take water. Do you find pure bottled water, you take it. If you can't take it, drink it. Totally gonna die. I really wish I had a sniper rifle or something. Cold as hell. I'm gonna put some clothes on fast. There we go. Nice, dude. A little lake house for me? I totally pimped this thing out, man.